If you were around in 1959 and told your friends that 10 years from now, we'll be sending men to the moon and bringing them back safely to Earth, you would have been laughed at, ridiculed, and probably told to see a psychiatrist. This was considered a fantasy at the time. Not too different than saying that in 2029, we're going to visit Proxima Centauri, the nearest star to the sun. Yet, on July 20th, 1969, that's what happened. Neil Armstrong took man's first step on the moon on that date. 1,000 years from now, when historians look back on the history of mankind, Neil Armstrong's name will likely still be remembered. The moon landing is perhaps man's greatest technological accomplishment ever in the history of human civilization. The 50-year anniversary of this momentous event is in 2019, and we should celebrate. This is not just a celebration for the United States, the flag of which these three men represented, but the entire world, because that landing represents the zenith of human technology and ingenuity. Yet this event should never have happened. The odds for success were very low. Even Neil Armstrong only gave it a 50% chance of success. Computer technology was measured in kilobytes and megahertz at the time, not terabytes and gigahertz of today, a million times less powerful. The astronauts had to be shielded from deadly cosmic rays. The number of stages involved in the rocket launch, from Earth orbit to lunar orbit, to descent on the moon, to ascent, to landing back on Earth, all had to be choreographed and practiced to perfection with little to no room for error. Safety margins were razor thin. The smallest anomaly could cause disaster. Everything had to work flawlessly. Is it any wonder that millions of people believe that we never landed there? Yet it happened, not just once, but 6 times over 3.5 years between 1969 and 1972 in multiple Apollo missions. But the very first mission had 2 life-threatening events that could have easily ended in disaster. These potential disasters are now mostly forgotten, but it's time to remember them on this anniversary. They remind us of how individual creativity and determination can turn catastrophe into stupendous success. The incredible moon landing and the moon takeoff disasters averted by Buzz Aldrin and Neil Armstrong is coming up right now. Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin were in the Eagle lunar module on their final descent. They were falling rapidly towards the surface of the moon at 20 feet per second. But when they looked out the window, they did not recognize anything they saw. They had not seen this terrain in any of their numerous simulations, nor seen it in dozens of photographs that they had studied from previous Apollo missions. It turns out that a navigational error and a faster than anticipated speed caused them to overshoot the planned landing zone by 4 miles. Now the terrain was not smooth, as it would have been had they landed in their designated landing site. Instead, there was a huge crater field and car-sized boulders, dangerous areas to land. But they had to land, and land soon, because they were running low on fuel. 400 feet or 122 meters before they hit the surface, Armstrong decided to level the craft and cruise horizontally until he could find a smoother surface to land on. This, of course, would use up more fuel. If they did not land before running out of fuel, they would drop to the ground like a rock. At best, they would almost certainly damage the craft beyond repair. Or they would have to abort the mission, which was equally risky because it was not known whether there was enough time to ignite the ascent engine before they hit the ground. And there was not going to be a rescue mission. They were flying to save their lives. There were 60 seconds of fuel left. They had not found a suitable landing spot.
60 seconds. Lights on. Down 2.5. Forward. Forward.
In Houston, they heard the 60-second low fuel alarm warning. In normal simulations, the craft was expected to land with plenty of fuel or 2 minutes of fuel left. But the 60-second mark, they were still about 100 feet or 10 stories above the moon's surface. Armstrong began to descend further.
Four forward, drifting to the right a little. Ready? 1.5. 30 seconds. Forward, just. Ready?
30 seconds left, they were still 10 feet or 3 meters off the ground. At this point, the thrust from the engine was kicking up so much moon dust that they could not tell exactly how far off the surface they were. All they could see were a haze of powder and a few boulders. The contact light finally came on and they were on the surface.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
Only 20 seconds of fuel was left and disaster had been averted. Houston controllers breathed a sigh of relief, but celebrated only mildly, knowing that the mission was long from over. There was supposed to be a 4-hour rest period before Armstrong and Aldrin were to explore the surface of the moon, but within 3 hours, they were eager and ready to go. After exploring the surface of the moon for about 2.5 hours, when they came back into the module, as they took their backpacks off, unbeknownst to them, at the time, Aldrin's backpack had snapped off something on the control panel. And as the astronauts were getting ready for some long overdue sleep, Aldrin noticed a small black object lying on the floor and realized it was a circuit breaker switch. Scanning the control panel, he noticed that the switch was missing from one that was labeled engine arm. Now, they could have broken numerous switches on that control panel and it would have made no difference, but this circuit breaker switch was special. It happened to be the one required in order to ignite the ascent engine so they could go back up into orbit. If the engine did not ignite, they could not return home and there would be no rescue mission. So this tiny black switch could potentially determine whether they lived or died. He told Houston, and they didn't immediately know what to do. They said, "We'll work on this down here, so you guys go ahead and go to sleep." Of course, these guys could not sleep with this looming catastrophe hanging over their heads. Contrary to the popular narrative, it was not a metal ballpoint space pen that Aldrin inserted into the circuit, but a spare plastic felt tip pen that he had brought with him on his spacesuit that saved the day and saved their lives.
I had gotten a felt tip pen so I could read the writings on the rendezvous charts. So I used the felt tip pen 2 hours before. Hey, we got circuit, we got power. So we were coming pretty close to not being able to come home.
Now, I want to add a couple of thoughts about the fact that there are millions of people in the world who don't believe that man has ever walked on the moon. Some stats are pretty surprising. In 1969, less than 5% of people doubted the authenticity of the video images they were seeing on their TV screens. But today, a full 6% of Americans doubt the moon landing ever took place. And over 50% of Russians refuse to believe that Americans set foot on the moon. Now, this may not be all that surprising because there's widespread government control of media and propaganda disseminated by the Russian regime. But the most surprising stat is that 25% of British people and 9% of French people, our allies, do not believe we landed on the moon. What would be the irrefutable proof that could convince people that we did land there? How about photos of the surface of the moon that shows the moon rover tracks, footprints, and photos of the abandoned lunar modules from the Apollo missions on the surface of the moon? Well, in 2009, we sent the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter partly for this purpose, and those photos are exactly what you're seeing right here. Arvinash here. If you like our videos, then consider subscribing and ring the bell so that you can be informed when we upload more fascinating videos. We make 1 to 2 videos a week. We'll see you in the next video.